Let's go! Things are lining up perfectly for a huge move in crypto right now. Guys, this is stuff you need to know if you're holding Bitcoin, Ethereum, Cardano, or any other cryptocurrency. Welcome back, everybody. My name is Cristiano, bringing you cryptocurrency videos every day, teaching you how to make money in this market. Guys, we need to jump straight into the Bitcoin price right now because we got a very special situation happening right now. Okay, so what do we have here on the 4-hourly time frame? You can see that we have an inverse head and shoulders. Now, if we go to the 1 hour, so we're previously on the 4 hour, you can see that it is looking like this, still an inverse head and shoulders, potentially about to break here. So what do we have here? What is the psychology behind an inverse head and shoulders? Well, what you have is the first shoulder here to the left, you have the head, and then you have the second shoulder to the right. Now, is the psychology of an inverse head and shoulder ticked? As you know, we want to see this as a reversal pattern. So we do not want to see this in the middle of somewhere, like going up with the Bitcoin price going up, down, forming the shoulder, head, and then, you know, breaking to the upside. This is not an inverse head and shoulder. So you need to see it come at a downtrend. And if we continue and we zoom out here, you can see that indeed, this is coming from a downtrend. The inverse head and shoulders is also, as a pattern, relatively broad and relatively big compared to the downtrend, which we also want to see. And now on the 4-hourly time frame, it is looking like this. And now it is even more clear, the downtrend, you have this wick here, so capitulation candle going up, final shakeout potentially before this becoming a reversal pattern to the upside. Now, these are very, very reliable patterns, meaning that more likely than not, if you see this break to the upside, and that means that we need to break this line here at 40,000, where is it? Let's zoom in here. 40,800 is the neckline right now. So if we break this, this means that the inverse head and shoulders is potentially going to play out. So what we can do is we can put in a trade here. If we break this, we go up, you wait for the local high, local top, you retest this, accumulate or add more to your trade right here, and then add more once we break this level. So basically, a little bit when we are breaking it, a little bit when we are retesting, and a little bit once we are breaking the previous local high of this breakout. So that is generally how I like to play these. And inverse head and shoulders is a strong pattern, a very tradable pattern. And if we look at the measured move from this, this is actually going to take us up to $50,000. Now, what we also need to pay attention to is that if we break this level, not only is that breaking the inverse head and shoulders, but it's also potentially going to have, this is going to be strong resistance. You already know that the orange box and the red line here is going to be strong resistance. But if we break that level, maybe that is going to give us enough fuel to also actually break the red line here. So ideally, you would want us to see a breakout out of the inverse head and shoulders. Where was it? Right here, break the inverse head and shoulders up to the upside, also break the red line here at $42,000, have a retest, and then off we go up to $50,000. So that is one thing you need to pay attention to right now. But if we don't see us break the inverse head and shoulders neckline, well, we got the next level of support here at $30,000. And you know, I still stand by, everything in between these red lines is just noise. We need to break this to the upside at $42,000, or we need to break down from $30,000. Before that, you know, accumulating on dips, always a good idea according to me. But, you know, not going to see decisive moves here until we break this and define market trends. But there's actually another thing I need to show you. So if we go back to the inverse head and shoulders here, if I flip on the Lux algo on the 4-hourly time frame, and I will do it right now, you will see that the Lux algo has not yet told us that the market is flipping, but I feel it is very close to doing it right now. And in fact, you can see that it's trying to kind of measure the market right now and maybe have a flip. But I think that if we see a breakout here, I think that also the LOX algo is going to give us a flip of the market, so a buy signal right here. But you always have to pay attention to where we are at when it comes to support and resistances. So I would not get into a trade, you know, a big trade until we are above $42,000 here. Even if we see a breakout here, just like I said, you can put in a little bit here, you can see it go up, and on the retest, you can add some more, and then once you break the swing high of the breakout, you can add a little bit more. So that's the safe way to do things. That's cool. Now, support and resistances here on Bitcoin, as you know, as I said, $42,000, big, big resistance. Do not underestimate this. And guys, if you want to trade this volatility, you're able to do so over on Bybit, $2,610 for free. If you're using my link right here, you can deposit Bitcoin, you can deposit Ethereum, whatever cryptocurrency basically they have available. They have Cardano as well. So there are opportunities in the market right now. If you want to get the LOX algo, 20% discount using the code STACKER20. Let's continue to talk about Ethereum, because you can see that we went up on Ethereum. We had a little bit of a retest here, found support at 2,400, went up, found support this time at 2,500, and now we are approaching the resistance at $3,000, but the big resistance is going to be at 3,310. So pay attention to that, guys. Jumping over to Cardano, just like I said, this orange box did hold up strong, and now we are, in fact, finding resistance here at $1.82 over on Cardano. So pay attention to all of these lines, guys. They are actually very important. Looking at traditional markets, they are looking good, supported here at my orange line on the S&P 500 futures. So this is bringing more confidence into the market. Let's see if this can continue going up. Then Bitcoin and the altcoins are going to go on an absolute run, according to me. Now, follow me on Twitter. If you are not already following me on Twitter, I do post here regularly. So things I am doing, things I'm watching, things I'm doing when it comes to trading and altcoin investing. And speaking of altcoins and investing, look at this bounce. I mean, Polygon has just been obliterating everything recently. In fact, this is very close to the previous all-time high, actually. And when you have to, what you have to remember here is that this one had a run from $1 to $1.50. So basically a 150% in just a couple of days here, from the 13th of May up to the 19th. So when this dropped, it dropped hard, but this is also seen one of the strongest, if not, yeah, basically out of the top 50, I haven't seen such a strong bounce in the altcoins. Now, I haven't been, you know, watching every single altcoin in the top 50, but this is definitely one of the altcoins that has the strongest bounce. And it just goes to show quality altcoins are also going to bounce back the hardest. In fact, if we go over to CoinGecko here, let's look at the top 50 and let's do the last 24 hours. You can see that indeed Polygon is the coin with the biggest bounce during the last 7 days. Also, Polygon is not actually right up here, which is weird. I mean, during the last 7 days, I guess, you know, they had that run up, that huge run up from $1 to $1.50 just before the 7 day break, basically. But also you have Rainicorn, of course, and Rainicorn has been doing well. It's up 100% today as well. It was up 100% yesterday. And a lot of people, you know, this is the thing, quality altcoins, a lot of people are making a lot of profit on Rainicorn since my video yesterday. Perhaps some of you got in and you are now thanking me for this. This is not my credit. If you are making insane profits on altcoins, it is all due to you, as well as if you lose a lot of money, it's also all on you. But what I can do is that I can give you my thoughts on different altcoins, and I am bullish on Rainicorn. It has been going up 200% since the drop. So that's very cool to see, or more than 200%, I believe. Actually, during the last 30 days, even with the drop included, it is up 220%, which is completely insane. But yeah, let me know down in the comment section which your favorite altcoin is and how big has the bounce been. Okay, pay attention to the inverse head and shoulders. Let's see if this is going to play out. I am going to keep you updated on Twitter. And until then, I will see you in the next one.